So Pearlene Portius, right, the character from my novel, I mean, she's two people in the book. She's the woman who gives birth. So Pearlene Portius is the woman who gives birth to Pearlene Portius. And through a strange accident, her mother's name is put on her birth certificate as her own name. So the character, the name comes up twice. But Pearlene Portius, the main character, is what in Jamaica we would call a Warner woman, which means really that she's very literally a woman who gives warnings, a kind of Cassandra figure, you know, a prophetess of doom. And we seem to have many of those in Jamaica, women who, through some kind of religious frenzy, they claim to see the future and they give these warnings. So that's who Pearlene Portius in the novel is. She's a woman who gives warnings. So years ago, I left Jamaica and I was studying in Manchester. And I remember waking up one morning and hearing a shout outside my window. And the sound was at once recognizable and not recognizable. And when I looked, there was a woman in the streets and she was shouting about floods and earthquakes. And everyone said she was crazy. And in a way, I guess she was crazy. But I recognize this woman, not her, but this performance. It was something that I used to see in Jamaica. And I suddenly wondered, what did it mean that this woman's prophecies made no sense in Europe? And then much later on, and that image stayed with me for a long time. And then much later on, I remember reading the statistics and finding out that between about 1960 to right up to the present, right up to 2000, the highest proportion of people sectioned off to mental hospitals in England were Jamaican women, and I just wondered what their stories were. Why would a woman who was completely sane in Jamaica be considered crazy when she moved to Europe? Did something happen? Was she really crazy, or was England just not able to understand her and her ways? And then I remember this woman who was shouting in the street, and that's basically what the story is about. It's about a woman who is considered completely sane in Jamaica, who leaves, and she's a woman of religious ecstasy, and she ends up giving a prophecy in England, and she's immediately carted off to a mental institution. And that's basically the whole story. And I don't think at the end I know if she's crazy or not. I think I wrote the book to answer that question, but by the end of the book I still hadn't answered that question, because I think it's complicated and it's probably a little bit of both. So there are two voices in The Last Warner Woman, L'Authentique Pearlene Portius. So one is the character of, it's Pearlene Portius's voice, the Warner Woman's voice, and the other is a writer who is interviewing her. And I realize I do this a lot. My last book was a collection of poetry called The Cartographer Tries to Map a Way to Zion. And there were also two voices in it. It was a voice of a cartographer who visits Jamaica and a Rasta man who disagrees with the cartographer. And I realize this is important to me. And what it is in both books is I want someone to disagree with me, that I have certain opinions, and oftentimes I'm arguing with myself, and what I have to do is that I have to split myself into two people and have that argument. And so throughout the book, Pearlene Portius, she keeps on interrupting the narrative, and she keeps on, you know, arguing with the writer and saying that's not how the story happened. And for the most part, you begin to believe her until the end you realize he has as much right to the story as she does. And a lot of the things he says, it's true in its own way. And because I'm looking at two cultures and how they collide, I never want to say that one culture is right and the other is wrong. I want to say that they both have truths. And so that was important to me, to have two versions of the truth, and both of them in their own way being equally true, even when they're contradicted with each other, sometimes quite radically. I think the world we live in now is a chaotic world, and it's a crazy world, and it doesn't make sense. And in that way, all of us are invested in stories. All of us are invested in narratives, whether we're conscious of it or not. When someone tells you about their life or what their ambition is or why they do the things they do, what they've done is that they've selected different aspects of that life, different points, and they've created a narrative and they've created a story, and that story makes sense. And the ways that all of us make sense of this world is that we create a narrative about it. But the world in itself doesn't make any sense whatsoever. The only time it makes sense is when we tell a kind of story about it. This is why I was born. I was born to do this. And that's making sense out of chaos. And fiction writers just do that more. They do that act every day, and they do that professionally. But it's doing the same things that we all do as humans. So the book that I would take with me anywhere is a book by Salman Rushdie, actually, probably not the book that most people would think. It's his novel After Midnight's Children, a novel called Shame, which is it's a fairy tale about Pakistan in those days. And I remember reading it and just being. It's the first time I became angry about how talented a writer was. It's the first time I threw a book across a room because I thought no writer should be able to write that astonishingly well and be that perceptive. And it was the first time I thought I probably will never be as talented as that. But there was suddenly this goal to aspire to. There are other books that have hit me in a way, and over years I've gone back to them and thought, oh, that wasn't that good. But Shame, every time I go back to it, I think it is every bit as good as I thought it was when I was a 17-year-old kid. And so I think that's one of the books I would always want to have with me.